Top story tonight is this. New at 6 this evening, a surprise setback in efforts to help the environment. The city of Nacogdoches is temporarily suspending the recycling of paper and plastic. Now, this is part of a much larger issue affecting cities all over East Texas. KDK's Matt Thibodeau has our story.
For the time, Nacogdoches will no longer be recycling paper and plastic. This due to China no longer taking recyclables from the U.S.
Basically, there's no money in those recyclables.
City of Nacogdoches engineer Steve Bartlett says China's move has stopped many from buying recycled products. Thus, recycling centers are not taking certain materials and they're piling up. And items such as paper and plastic are headed to the city landfill.
The city wants to look for a way to continue a recycling program. So right now, this is kind of a placeholder until we can see things improve.
And it's not just in Nacogdoches. Cities all around East Texas are running into the same situation.
The city of Tyler says they are preparing for this eventuality. Recycle facilities are having to secure new markets for the recycled products since China stopped taking this huge quantity of material. Other markets are being flooded with these materials. Regardless, people around Nacogdoches say recycling is too important to quit.
I think recycling should be one of the top priorities, so any money that's going towards it is worth it.
An idea that hasn't escaped the city.
Recently, we have added a cardboard baler, which is going to allow us to take our recycled cardboard and bale it and be able to sell it, hopefully for a return on that investment for a profit.
Nacogdoches also still recycles glass, but it is handled by a private organization, a route locals hope the city can take with paper and plastic.
It's a renewable resource that we can use just for our own production of goods in the United States.
But until a solution is found, paper and plastic will still be brought to the city landfill. Matt Thibodeau, KETK News.
By the way, Nacogdoches says they hope to resume services at some point in the near future, but as of now, they don't have the exact date.